being brought through so many deaths where I taste the blood and I keep getting hit in the back of the head and then to the chest. So there has to be a lot of tragedy because now I just... Do you understand the tragedy, ma'am, over here? Or the car accident? Because when a soul puts... Do you understand the accident? Okay. So what happened is when a soul puts me in a car and they switch my seat, that's my symbol for where I carry, or the person carries, some type of survivor's guilt. Like plans change, or if I was driving, or if they didn't switch cars. How do you understand that?
Sorry. My best friend passed away when he was driving home from my house, and
you carry that guilt of saying, if I didn't tell him to leave,
yes,
or if I begged him to stay,
yes,
this accident never would have happened. And somehow his death is my fault.
Every day.
And he says, can you... Oh, he's tough.
Yeah,
he said to me, he goes, can you tell her to knock the shenanigans? That's not the word he used, but shenanigans off.
Yeah.
Fair enough. So what he would like you to do is to imagine him standing in front of you, perfectly healthy with the suitcase open at the bottom of his feet.
Yeah.
He'd like you to put in this suitcase any should've, could've, would've, only if, any negative emotion that is holding you back from healing, and put in this suitcase and hand it back to him with love. And then he goes to me, he goes, Theresa, he goes, we were more than friends.
He was like a soulmate to me in that way, and he was everything. And so when he died, it was...
Did you remember him at your milestones? Like
every milestone.
If there was like a graduation or like a wedding. You have children?
I have a daughter.
Okay.
Yeah.
And even through that, you remember him and you honor him. So know that he wants to thank you for that. For every breath that you take and every milestone you achieve, wanting to thank you for including him in that memory. Do you still drive past the accident?
It was right by the house that I grew up in, and I tried to avoid that area for a long time.
But he just showed me you driving by it.
Yeah, I was actually home recently, so I drove by it recently.
So validating that when you did that, know that his soul was with you at that exact moment?
Yeah.
And he says, but know that I died instantly because he hit me in the back of the head. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
You still have some of his things?
Yeah, I have a T-shirt. I have his hat. I have a bunch of things that are really special that I keep in a drawer.
What was with his eyes? Because he keeps lifting up his sunglasses, his glasses at me, and it like kind of looks at me like from a side eye.
So yeah, he always had like funny glasses that he would wear, and he did have something like wrong with one of his eyes. He was kind of colorblind and face blind, so he had some difficulty seeing, and so he had a bunch of funny glasses.
So just validating his personality, right? That's what I want. I want souls to validate their personality, because you're the only one that knows your loved one's personality. Validating, this is how he needs you to remember him, not remember him suffering, or more importantly, wanting you to carry that burden of that.
Yeah.
Okay.